Today we're heading to one of my favorite restaurants in Vegas, Crab Corner.
Yeah, and I've known brothers Mark and John for years.
Good to see you, brother. What's going on? How are you?
What's happening?
These Maryland transplants just finished some construction here, and they want a tank to top things off.
Tell us what you guys got us here for.
Crab tank. We wanted to showcase our crabs, man.
So you guys just want crabs and no fish in the tank, correct?
Yeah.
Crab tank. Cool. I love it.
Yeah, but isn't it supposed to be a crab restaurant?
This one's for people to see. People come in and look at it, understand what they do, where they live.
Oh, display tank, something to show it off.
Yes, got it.
Phew, this is for their pet crabs.
Yeah, these blue crabs are for the customers to look at.
Well, what are the crabs looking at?
People eating salads? Have you guys decided on where you want to put it yet?
This is what we got right now. We got this little guy over here.
Okay.
It makes the most sense for us to just replace that.
You're gonna have people coming in out of kitchen with hot stuff.
Right.
It's probably better if you move it to a different location.
Okay. I'm with you.
Yeah. All right, maybe leave that one there and do something different.
Maybe over here.
Over there,
maybe
let's go. Let's check it out, no?
The whole area here.
Dude, this is not bad. It's away from the kitchen.
Yeah, focal point. Once the thing goes up in the summer, they'll be able to see it from indoors and outdoors.
Oh, that whole
here.
World door goes up?
All goes up.
So I feel like the beach or something.
Yeah, it's kind of cool. Tell me exactly the whole process behind how the crabs are they
caught on a boat.
We fly them in fresh every day from the Chesapeake Bay.
Cool.
Chesapeake Bay, I was there. I grew up out there.
Dude, geography's not your strong suit. You grew up near Oyster Bay. The Chesapeake Bay is in Maryland, where these guys grew up.
Whatever, dude, I'm sure they connect somewhere.
Flown in live crab right off the
every
boat.
Every day, yeah.
Dude, what about a boat, yeah.
A who?
A boat. What we do is we have a half a boat, the front of the boat, come off to a point. And then what we could do is we could make acrylic windows sitting on a stand so the acrylic looks like the boat. And we do the bottom half, which will actually look like a boat.
It's like it's crashing out of our wall, like the boat's coming through the restaurant?
Exactly, like it's coming right out of the wall.
I like it. The only concern I have is make sure it's authentic. It looks like kind of like one of the crab boats that maybe we use.
You got pictures?
You can kind of take a peek at it, that one there.
Dude, we can do that whole thing. We can do the dock area like that. Dude, that'd be great.
You know, crabs come from brackish water, so.
Yeah.
Brackish water is where the freshwater rivers run into the salt water.
These crabs live in the same kind of water as some gobies and cichlids we put in tanks. So we'll make sure that the parameters for the crabs match the Chesapeake Bay.
Okay, no that was problem. My only concern. If you can do it, I'm happy.
All right, fellas.
Awesome.
Good to see you.
Thank you so much.
This is one restaurant tank crabs will be on board with. The bow-shaped acrylic tank will be docked on top of a 4-foot stand. Concealed underneath will be the tank's life support system. The precious cargo inside will be blue crabs straight from the Chesapeake Bay. A custom-made wooden exterior will replicate the look of an authentic crab boat. First port of call, Crab Corner.
The first order of business for the Crab Corner tank is to match the look of a crabbing boat. The front has a curve to it. So to achieve this, we'll attach two pieces of acrylic together.
We're gonna bend this piece right here, and then we're gonna take another piece and also bend it right here too. Right. The problem we're gonna have is the material when it meets. My main concern is that it's strong, because it's gonna be definitely a weak point on the tank.
There's 800 pounds of water pushing against the seam where the acrylic meets. We gotta make sure this holds like a dam.
Usually, you know, we do a butt joint, you know what I'm saying? I don't know after we take the pieces out of the oven how it's gonna bend and how this joint's gonna be. Here, grab those pieces.
Yeah.
Squeeze that right there. Okay, now look, you see this point right here? You see how that's gonna come? That's what's gonna happen.
The two sections of acrylic might not line up when they come out of the oven. Only the tips of the acrylic pieces are touching. And we need more surface area to create a fail-safe bond.
I have to cut here, and cut here, and then round that, and then round that, so that glue joint will hold.
Redneck needs to keep a close watch on this build. If the angles aren't exact and the bond's not perfect, this boat can sink before we get a chance to set sail.
All right, so you got this, right?
Yeah.
All right, I'm leaving it in your hands.
Wade and I come up with a plan to bond two pieces of acrylic for the boat tank. But I tweaked it a little bit.
Brad, what's going on?
I'm just getting ready to stick this in the oven. We're not gonna have a seam in the front. With a complex seam like this, we run the risk of it leaking. Instead, if we form one piece of acrylic to the shape we want, we're guaranteed to be watertight. One full piece, both sides.
So you're just gonna put the back
on it? And the top and bottom.
I gotta admit, Redneck's plan makes a lot of sense. I was going for the pointy look, but the point in the facade will do the trick.
All right, so this might work.
Okay.
Just do me a favor, don't tell anybody I've been outsmarted by a redneck, all right? Just get it in the oven. Let's go.
This isn't the first time or the last time this will happen.
We're in Vegas installing a blue crab tank at Crab Corner. Everything was going fine until it was time to put the crabs in.
We had special crabs for here for display, and now you tell me in this restaurant, they're gone.
I talked to the chef, he said they're gone.
Oh, Brett.
We're in a crab restaurant.
So what are we gonna do now?
I have no idea, but I'm only kidding. Nah, Izzy's got him. That's what you get for being such a crab.
I can't believe you, dude.
What can I say? I've always been able to entertain myself in a pinch.
Yeah, I gotta give you a pinch.
Yeah.
Dude, let's get these crabs in.
Let's do it.
Look at this guy, huh? Feisty, huh? All right, you're going in your tank, buddy, okay? You know these guys are okay being out of water. For days, they can stay out of water. Look at this guy, huh?
Dude, it's like a battle royal. These guys are vicious.
You're getting flipped over. There you go. All right.
Last one.
The client wanted the bottom of the tank to look like the Chesapeake Bay. So he took an actual photo of the bay, made a wrap, and lined the tank with it. That's why we're not covering it up with sand.
All right, listen, all the crabs are in. Let's get the rest of the canopy on, the stand. Let's wipe this down and get ready for the customer.
Let's do it. Grab the bottom, turn it.
Everybody press it up.
Grab the front. Watch it, guys. Watch your fingers.
Come to me.
Forward.
Be careful. Brad, let's get the wheelhouse up there.
Dude, I'm ready to go sailing.
It looks great. Man, it was a long day.
Long day? It's night.
All right, it was a long night. Right. You know what? Today was amazing. We had two installs in one day. But you know what? ATM's in the house, and we got it done.
Ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Mark, John, come on in.
Wow, dude. Oh my God. That's what I'm talking about. Wow, it's a boot, man. You guys crushed it.
You guys nailed it, dude, honestly.
When they walked in, I think they thought they were in Maryland.
This is insane.
When people walk into your place, this is the first thing that they're gonna see.
I think right here is perfect. People can see it from every part of the restaurant. That's about the size of a real crab boat. They kept it authentic. And that boat is a crab boat, and it's coming right out the wall. And that's exactly what we wanted. Looks like you just pulled it right out of the water. I mean, it just takes your breath away.
This whole side is actually removable and very easy to maintain the aquarium. So this side comes out, you can get underneath it, you can adjust the chiller, do the filters, take care of it, and put it back.
How could they drive the boat?
It has a wheel up top.
Well, you got the fly bridge up there. Just get in the seat and cruise out to the bay.
I think the crabs love it.
The crabs definitely love it.
We want your customers to love it too.
People can walk up right on the glass and see the size of the crabs and everything. Now we can actually show the customers firsthand the males and the females and which ones are which. The females had the red tip claws and the males had the blue tip claws.
Like nail polish.
Just like it.
Are you glad that it's over here and not by the kitchen?
Yeah, I think I'm really happy that we landed on this spot as opposed to over here because people are going to be, you know, over here looking at the crabs nonstop and they would have gotten in the way of our servers going in and out of the kitchen.
I think that was a really good idea. You guys moved it around and actually really put it right where it was supposed to be.
If it was over there, it would have been stuck at the dock. This one's ready to sail.
This one's ready to sail for sure, but it's tied up and keep the crabs right here. Customers will see them and I can't be any happier. You guys really nailed it.
Making this boat wasn't easy, it was difficult. This front piece is all one piece, it was thermoform. We had to put the acrylic in the oven and shape it. The whole thing sits at 10.5 feet tall. You got the fly bridge up top so they can cruise around, see everything, see the buoys.
He kept it authentic then, that's exactly what we wanted.
It's 100 gallons and you're looking close to 1,000 pounds sitting here.
Wow.
All right, you got a steel structure that holds it up so you don't have to worry about any of your clients or customers in front of it. Underneath the aquarium, you got a full filtration system, two of them. You got an open system and a closed system. You got one that circulates the whole bottom of the tank and the top of the tank. So you have complete circulation in the tank. You have a chiller in there that regulates the temperature for the crabs just like it at home.
Great.
So these crabs are gonna be happy.
Okay.
This thing is ready to go.
Wow, man, you guys, I knew I had total faith and complete confidence in it, but I gotta tell you, these crabs look pretty happy and they're swimming around. This is just unreal. This is incredible.